Hi everyone, welcome to the Royal Saskatchewan Museum's Bird Mondays. So the last few weeks, we've looked at a ton of different birds here in the province. And so I thought I'd switch it up a little bit this week and talk about ways that people can contribute to our understanding of birds in the world and right here in Saskatchewan. What I thought to start off, I would show you a couple phone applications that you can download and put on your phone to help you identify birds and also keep track of some of the birds that you might see in the areas that you're looking for birds. So the first app that's really, really interesting and probably the biggest birding app that's out there is called eBird. Now, eBird is run by the Cornell Lab of Ornithology, and it allows you to submit information on where and when you've seen different birds on your travels. So you could be out for a hike, you could be out for a drive, or you could be just sitting in your backyard seeing what comes to your feeder. And what eBird allows you to do is submit information on all of the birds that you've seen. Couple other neat eBird features is you can go out and you can look for birding hotspots, which is all tracked by the app, and you can also download checklists of bird species in the area that you're living. So all of that information goes to Cornell and it's made available to researchers and scientists to help with conservation and bird management. So any information that you submit to that app is really, really important from a science perspective for bird conservation and management. So I'd encourage you to check out eBird. It's a free app, freely available, and super easy to use on your phone. So the other phone app that I wanted to introduce folks to is called iNaturalist, and it's a little bit different from eBird. How iNaturalist operates is you usually take a picture of something that you're unsure about the identification of, and then the group of iNaturalist users helps you identify what is in that particular picture. Lots of people use it for birds, but you can submit pictures of lots of other things. Things like mammals, plants, insects that you might see, and the whole iNaturalist community gets together and helps you to identify what's in your picture. All of that information, again, is stored in a central repository that can be used and freely used by scientists and researchers that do work on lots of different types of biodiversity across the world. Again, it's a free app. You can download it to your phone. You can also use it to find hotspots in your communities of where people may have seen different things, whether it's a unique bird or a unique plant. And you can use that information to go out on a little bit of an adventure and find some of the unique biodiversity that's present here in Saskatchewan. So check out iNaturalist. It's another really great tool that citizen scientists can use. Now, eBird and iNaturalist are absolutely great phone apps, and they really contribute to an international effort to understand birds and understand biodiversity kind of internationally across the world. But what about programs and things happening closer to home? So one of the programs that's really near and dear to my heart right now is the Saskatchewan Breeding Bird Atlas. So this is a program that lasts for 5 years. We're entering the last year of the Saskatchewan Breeding Bird Atlas. And essentially what the Breeding Bird Atlas wants to do is to document breeding birds and where they are all across the province of Saskatchewan. This relies on amateur birders to record information on birds that they've seen. Again, it can be whether or not you're on a hike, you're on a drive, or you're sitting in your backyard. All of that information is extremely valuable to help us understand the distribution and the abundance of birds here in Saskatchewan. So I really encourage folks to check out their website, sk.birdatlas.ca. And please, please, please try to get involved this year. Every little bit of information counts and helps to understand our bird community here in the province of Saskatchewan. And last but not least, there's a new program for those of folks who live in and near Regina that the Royal Saskatchewan Museum is participating in this year called the City Nature Challenge 2021. This is a really great opportunity for folks in the city to get outside, explore the city, and look for and document native biodiversity here in the city of Regina. It's going to make use of that app I just talked about called iNaturalist. So we're hoping that everyone can download iNaturalist, go out with your phone, start taking pictures of lots of things, submit it to the iNaturalist City Nature Challenge 2021 Regina area, and there'll be experts on hand to help you identify all of the neat things that you find in Regina. From my perspective, please keep an eye out for all of those cool birds that you might be seeing in your backyard. But don't forget about everything else. Every little bit of documentation that we can get on native biodiversity is really, really important and useful information. So please keep that on your radar between April 30th and May 3rd, the City of Regina Nature Challenge 2021. Good luck, everyone. I hope you're able to get outside and have some fun with a couple of those apps that I talked about and get involved with the Saskatchewan Breeding Bird Atlas and the City Nature Challenge in the coming months. It's a great time to get outside and be safe. Talk to you later. Enjoy this Bird Monday.